guys. So you're thinking about dating a single mom and you want to know if she's a keeper. Well, in this video, I'm going to give you a bunch of signs that she is a great single mom that you could consider dating and feel safe. If you're new to my channel, my name is Anna Jorgensen. I'm a dating coach for men. And if you haven't already, click subscribe and the notification bell so you don't miss any of my Just the Tip Tuesday videos. Okay, so I've already done the video on the pros and cons of dating single moms. So in this video, we're just going to go into the signs to watch for that she's a good single mom that you can feel safe in considering dating without worrying too much. So the first thing that I would suggest looking for is her relationship with her parents. So are her parents actually still together, and are they involved in her and her child or children's lives? If she has a good, solid family support system and or friends that are there for her and her child, then that child is likely going to have had a strong, hopefully masculine figure somewhere in the child's life that will round out the home. Now, yes, there's going to be some people who won't like this because they're like, yeah, what about like gay couples with kids? Well, guess what? My channel's not for that. So I'm just talking to the straight guys looking for single moms. All right. So number two, she's not a partier. She doesn't drink excessively or do drugs. If she doesn't even go out drinking with the girls, that is super bonus because her priorities are in the right place. Maybe once in a while, but she never gets drunk or high. These are my list. I can make them any which way I want to. Okay, number three. Her kids are her priority. She's a good mom if she's got that straight. These are her kids. They're her responsibility. She needs to make them her priority. But here's the but. She works to accommodate you. She works on making room for you in her life and in the life of the family unit. So it's not just all about her and the kids and their schedule. It's about compromise and working to make sure that you're a family unit and that your needs are also met within the group. Four, she's financially stable. She either has a job or she has some means of supporting the family that doesn't solely rely on the ex. Five, she discloses from the beginning that she's got kids or a child. So she's not trying to hide that. She's disclosing right up front. That shows you that this woman's got character and that she knows what her priorities are, that family is a priority. You do want a woman who's going to make family a priority, even if you don't want any more kids with her or in general. Six. Oh, you're not going to like this one, but she doesn't give it up right away. So she will want to get to know you before just having sex with you. She's going to vet the prospects of who she's going to let into her life and the lives of her children or child before she gets intimate and allows intimacy to cloud judgment on what's going to actually be a good fit in the world, not in the bedroom. Seven. She has standards and sticks to them, but kindly. So she knows her standards. She'll stick to them, but she'll be kind and gentle about expressing what those are and following through on what she needs to follow through with in order to be able to maintain those standards. She won't discredit herself or go against her own moral judgments just to be with someone. I can't remember what we're on, so we're just going to say next. Next one. She's okay being single forever. So in other words, she's not desperate. She's not just going to take the first guy who shows up just because she's lonely or desperate or needy or any of those things. So she's okay on her own, but she likes something about you. And yeah, she wants to make room in her life for you. Next one. She actually goes slow in order to make sure that you're truly compatible, that your goals and beliefs and your values are in alignment for the long haul. Next one, she displays emotional and financial stability. So those could actually be separated, but we're going to throw them in together. So she's financially stable. She's not in debt up to her eyeballs. Maybe a little bit right now, depending on the world situation, but generally speaking, she's responsible and emotionally stable. She's not going to be a drama queen, or she doesn't have lots of emotional baggage. You can watch my videos on that to see what that would look like. So run away from those type of girls. ladies, women, chicks. Here's another one that's super important. She actually encourages you to pursue your hobbies and your passions and your life purpose. This one's major. This one should be, without question, something that you, as having your own standard, will require from any relationship you're in, whether it's with a single mom or with any other woman. You need to have someone who's going to support you in doing the things that you feel compelled to do that satisfy or fulfill your own soul, hobbies, passions, interests, goals, ambitions, all those things. You want to make sure that she's supportive of you and she wants you to be happy in doing those things. Another one is that she prioritizes her health. So if she's, you know, pretty healthy and relatively fit, she hasn't just used having children as an excuse to let herself go. Well, that's a really good quality because you know what you're signing up for. Another good quality to actually look for is if she's either a widow or she's been single for a while. And this, again, just kind of proves that, well, not the widow thing, but it proves that she's not desperate because she didn't just settle with whoever showed up first. She's been on her own for long enough to know that she's content and capable of being on her own, but she's also now open to allowing someone into her and perhaps her children's lives. Another great quality is if her kids are respectful. So whatever age they are, I mean, if they're toddlers, it's going to be a little bit different than if they're, you know, 8 or 9 or 15. But if her children are respectful to you and well-mannered, well, that shows a lot about her character, not just the children, especially if they got a deadbeat dad who's not in the picture. So if she's managed to raise great kids in spite of what their father might have been, then that's extra bonus point. Okay, next one. This is a really good one too. So if you've been able to spend enough time with her to have met the children and been in their company, if there's a disagreement and you and her don't agree on the way the parenting should be done in that particular situation, she doesn't take the children's side in front of them. So there's an agreement, preferably actually expressed before any of this would happen, that you agree that you're going to stand together in unity so that the kids don't divide and conquer, and that you'll discuss behind the scenes what should happen. And even if she's the one that has the final say, because they're her kids, depending on how far along in the relationship you are and what the situation is, that she is respectful enough of your primary relationship, because you guys hopefully will be the ones that will be still together after the kids leave and go on their merry way. So she will stick by you and then work it out with you behind the scenes and then come back in with a united front for the children so that you're always together, so that those kids can't come between you by playing you against each other. They still will try though, because that's what they do. Along these lines is that she not only considers your opinion, but she values your opinion about the children. So you are part of the family. This doesn't come right away. It has to be earned through time and example and trust and behavior, but she actually respects and values your opinion about how the parenting is done. And if she has a respectable relationship with the ex that is amicable, she doesn't have to be best friends with the dude, but if she doesn't actually say anything bad about him, not that she makes excuses, but if she just is respectful, then that shows a lot about her good character as well. And as well as along those lines is that if she's got a good relationship with her ex-in-laws, now that's not always possible, but when a woman has a bad relationship with her ex or all her exes and the in-laws, everybody else is wrong and she's like the bitter pill to every berry she's ever been with, there's a lot of bees in that, then to me that's a red flag, because what's the common denominator, sugar? On another note, or not on the same note, it's super important that you know before going in if you actually even want a family. If you don't, then you should not be fooling around with a woman like this. If she's just a hoe at the bar and she just needs a one-nighter, then that's something different. But you don't want to get into a relationship with a woman with kids unless you know for sure that you're okay signing up for the long haul, because it's just not a good thing to do to those kids. And even though, no, it's not your responsibility, you're just going to end up with headaches and heartbreak if you don't figure some things out at the very beginning. So always make sure that you have compatible beliefs, values, and goals before you get into any relationship. Another great sign is that she displays responsible domestic abilities. So she's able to keep the household going. And even if she's working full time, she's got somebody else helping out with, you know, keeping the house clean or what have you. Or maybe it's the kids who are actually chipping in with domestic chores, but she's got the household taken care of and everything's running smooth. As well, if you can see through her children or how she interacts with her children that she displays gentle, nurturing, mothering qualities, then that may translate into what you're going to get with her as well. And the super big bonus is if her parents are still together and are happy, well, that is a very good example for someone who is now a single mom. If you have anything else to add, write it in the comments below.